Today is St. Patrick's Day 2020, and we are back.
Do you know the date?
The 17th?
Of what?
March.
Okay, good job.
Hey, thanks for asking me stupid questions. We're back at it. Sean is up. He's in the garage, too, and we brought our good friend Jake.
Jake Yodakai is here. The Jake is happy. It's St. Patrick's Day. Love celebrating the original slaves. The Irish.
They are.
They are. Yeah, yeah. I mean, I say that with pride. I'm only 10% Irish, but I like to celebrate that.
Right. Only 10.
Only, that's a surprising number.
Yeah. Jake is 10% of everything. 10% okay. Irish. He's 10% African. He's 10% Wakataki.
Oh, okay.
Indian.
All right. Oh. Yeah, that makes sense. That nice. Makes sense.
But we've been missing for a while, but with the whole Corona issue, we're back.
Yeah, we got some time on our hands. You know, I switched my schedule around, so I'm full time again. Don't have the free time that we had before, and Paulo switched his days off for the time being, so it kind of interfered with our casting schedule.
Well, and I was, the Jake was, I think in Australia they call it a walkabout, but right. I was more of a spiritual reckoning.
Like a vision quest?
It was just a reckoning.
A reckoning.
I was just on a reckoning across the country. I actually met a good, I think a lot of us are could be fans of him. Didn't know what to think of this guy, but Kid Rock is a huge pickleball player.
I heard he's got some game.
He's got an indoor pickleball court, four courts. Got to play 2 days for him, gave him some private lessons. We bob with the ba, you could say. Then after that, did some peyote with Jared Leto right before he went on his 12-day isolation.
Yeah, he had no idea with the...
Yeah. So I was with Jared about 4 weeks ago. He's a weird cat, that Jared. But yeah, that's what I did. And then we finally finished our yurt on our 20-acre homestead back in the backcountry here in the beautiful San Ynez Valley.
Nice.
Yeah, we put compass to work because a lot of people don't know we had a magnetic north magnet implanted in his neck so he always... knows where
he
to
just
go.
Leans.
Yeah, he helped us get those south-facing windows.
My man, good to have you too. All right.
We're going to go ahead and call this the Corona Case Files.
Case Files, yes.
Ooh, is it like the X-Files?
Kind of, maybe. I mean, we can go into all kinds of conspiracy theory right now.
Did you think that was Scully? She was Scully?
I love Scully.
Yeah.
She was hot.
Gillian Anderson?
I mean, for sure. Yeah, yeah. And Scully, the name Scully, it's like you're getting skull, getting head.
That could have been probably this.
I think so.
That could have been the meaning behind it.
Redheads are known for that.
I bet you she's amazing. She's on my top 10 list of redheads now.
That she was. No, I think she originally was.
She was.
I think she originally was.
Yeah, she's a good redhead.
Mm-hmm. For sure. No, I never was into the show, but I was definitely into her.
Oh, I love the show.
She was always very serious.
Yeah, Amanda and I, my wife, beautiful wife, Amanda, light of my life. We used to watch X-Files every Sunday. It was a good time.
Oh, wow. Yeah. That was one I missed. I missed a couple shows in the 90s, 80s. I mean, 2000s.
Well, you have to elevate your altitude before you watch it.
Action Bronson? You ever see Action Bronson on YouTube?
Yes,
He watches, what's the alien show? Alien... Oh, I can't remember the show, but it's an alien show.
Imagine that. You can't remember something.
I know, but I don't watch the show on Discovery Channel, but his whole show on YouTube is him getting blazed out.
Oh, yeah.
And watching Alien Encounters or whatever it is on Discovery Channel. So,
yeah, interesting.
It's not a far-fetched idea there.
No, it's not.
You know, he's got
so
hundreds and thousands of views.
Where do we begin? You know, we've missed a lot. You know, we've missed Thanksgiving,
Super Bowl,
Christmas,
the Astros cheating. We've missed
so much.
Oh, yeah,
Kobe.
Well, the pickleball championships got canceled as well due to the coronavirus.
How did you feel about that?
It's heartbroken, but I understand this whole social distancing thing's a little weird. But you know, the Jake will adapt as always.
And with the almost imminent threat of lockdown coming up or shelter in place orders coming up.
Oh, yeah.
What's your feelings on that?
The Jake's very disappointed in the United States government for this fear mongering.
Mm-hmm.
I will say this, that you should exercise your Second Amendment right. And when they do lock you down on shelter in place, the next step after that is martial law. And you know the last time that America was in martial law? Do you know?
No, tell us.
Hurricane Katrina, they enacted martial law. Their stories, they went door to door to confiscate guns. and they tried to take this 89-year-old woman's guns, and she refused. They arrested her, broke her hip while they were arresting her. Oh. There are stories of people jumping in like their John boats or Jack boats or whatever. Yeah.
John boats,
throwing all their guns, going to their hunting cabinets in the swamp, and holing up for weeks until martial law was lifted so they couldn't take their guns.
Because that was, wow.
Yeah, martial law is no joke, man. There's no constitution anymore when martial law is enacted.
Is it by state, or if they say martial law, is it the nation?
Like in that situation, they just enacted martial law in
New Orleans
or the parish of whatever those parishes were. But with they can do it by state, they can do it by county, but if they do it nationally, that's when the military comes in. The military is now our government or the National Guard.
Right.
And the person in charge of the National Guard is, or the military, is the president. He's the commander-in-chief, and there is no more constitution.
Wow. Crazy.
You're right.
So what other times has there been martial law called? The civil rights times?
I think the National Guard was called, right? But I don't think that was civil. I don't think martial law was enacted. The National Guard was called. Yeah, the National Guard was called to quell those riots.
Right. But I can't think of another time
where it's actually enforced.
Or when they should. Like the riots in L.A. when they were burning L.A. down. They
never did.
Martial law wasn't enacted. They had curfews enacted.
Chicago fires were a big one. Watts riots.
Yeah.
But never, I don't think.
Yeah, I don't know if Watts riots, they might have enacted martial law, but, I mean, that's crazy that we're going to enact martial law for
a cold virus.
Cough? Respiratory illness?
How scary is it when you see someone cough right now? We went grocery shopping.
I'm not worried about it at all.
I'm not scared at all.
So Lincoln, we're at Sprouts in Santa Barbara.
Well, that's your first problem.
Right, well, we're doing...
Every granola cruncher in the fucking county's there.
Well, at least he's doing a job there or something and helping out somebody, right? And Lincoln sneezes by the apples. Dude, I've never got so many bad eyes in my life.
You know what you say? Fuck them.
Fuck them.
You know, if I had little kids his age, what I would do is I would go get like the Tyvek suits, you know, the white painter suits. I would go get that, and I'd put those N95, the big respirators on them, goggles, and I'd just fucking take my kids shopping. Just dressed like that, and you're dressed in a tank top and flip-flops, like it ain't no thing.
Right?
Yeah, we just got back from Colorado last week, and we were in the Denver airport. There was this mother pushing her stroller with, I want to say, like a 3 to 4 year old kid, and the kid was out walking, just normal clothes. Mom was gloves, face mask, like everything, and the kid had nothing.
Nothing.
But in truth to that, it's like kids of a certain age are not susceptible at all.
Kids aren't getting it. High school kids aren't getting it even. It's like, give me a fucking break, people. I can't believe. Okay, so for shits and giggles.
Okay.
Last night I watched Contagion.
Oh.
Right, there was also Outbreak,
and then I'm going to watch I Am Legend. So I'm making Angela watch all these. Amanda, excuse me. Angela's my niece. She was with us yesterday. Yeah, that's my brother's girl. But we watched that, and it makes Amanda get nightmares, and she has a hard time sleeping. So
with I Am Legend?
No, with Contagion.
Oh, okay.
She had a hard time sleeping. Breakout was with the one with the monkey, right?
No.
That's 12 Monkeys?
12 Monkeys.
Red Zone? Hot Zone? Hot Zone's the book.
Oh, I don't know. If I think you're
just throwing out words.
If I'm going apocalyptic movies, top of my list is Book of Eli.
Oh, so.
Right. Oh, wait. Which one's Book of... I haven't seen that.
Book of Eli is Denzel.
Oh, I haven't seen it.
Where he's blind.
Dude.
What?
Really?
What's wrong with that?
That's like half the punchline of the movie. You just ruined it for anybody who hasn't seen it.
You mean the movie that came out in 2012?
But it's still. Okay. That's like saying Old Yeller dies at the end of Old Yeller.
I just got Disney Plus. Hey, okay, so something I've been wanting to ask everybody with the whole Corona thing. If you have a conspiracy or you are a conspiracy theorist.
Oh, yeah.
What is your favorite one, or what do you think?
My favorite one, this is the Jake speaking again, is this was created in a lab. We put tariffs on China. What better way to get back at the American government without having to go to war than by creating this, and now look what has happened. It's come to America, and what has been the net result? Our economy's crashing, stock market's crashing, we're going to end up on martial law, and all the while, the Chinese government is giggling in the corner like schoolgirls.
Well, because they don't care about their citizens.
They don't give a fuck. They killed the ones that
were
sick.
They don't care. They don't care about their...
Well, think about what they used to do with population control, with only having one kid, and...
They ordered 400 incinerators. to come over a month ago.
Oh, my God.
Because they're burning bodies. Oh, you're too sick? Oh, well, hey, surprise. All of our portable hospitals are done with.
They're like, hey.
What's your favorite?
Population.
You know, I'm somewhere along the lines with the man-created virus. What better way to get everybody to an equal playing field in terms of economy and global power than create a global pandemic to where everything just crashes and it's all like everybody's back to square zero, square one.
And it doesn't hurt the Chinese. That's the thing, is who's going to be hurt the most in this?
I forget whoever's in charge of the Chinese government like donated like 900,000 coronavirus test kits. And I was like, that's them just like,
oh, hey,
just
fuck
laughing
you.
At us, you know, just pissing on us.
Or there's the other conspiracy that the Democrats.
Oh, I love that it's political. Oh, God. Right and left. I'm like, what about Italy? Like, they're like, if Italy goes down while this is happening.
Who gives a fuck? Italy's population is 50% of their population is over 70. That's why there's so many people sick there.
And they're fucking dirty.
They live on dirty water.
I'm going to say it. They're dirtier.
Well, yeah. I mean, especially those Basques.
Have you seen how old that city is? I'm sure it's asbestos and just all that nasty shit.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
They had it coming.
Yeah.
Says the other 52% of me.
What? The Jake's 10% Italian. Or Italian, as my mother likes to say.
It's a hard eye.
Hard eye? Yeah. Italian, Italian?
I typically get Italian dressing from Italy.
It's authentic.
What's yours, Paolo?
I had the whole, you know, it's so easy to do the political thing. Well, I like the other end, though. Someone was like, for the Trump part, this is the Trump part, they're like, this is going to be his big victory. He's gonna catch up, and he's gonna make sure coronavirus is eradicated from the country, and he's gonna be the dude. This is like his chance for his big home run, and I was like, come on, it's probably helping him. It is probably helping him, all this stuff, and Democrats are already shooting themselves in the foot. Like, they're already.
But you got to think, what Trump's always hung his hat on the economy, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that's his thing. Like, that's what he did the best, and the economy is.
Oh, it's not kind of right now.
Well, at least we're going to get $1,000 checks.
Now, is that for sure?
I watched the press conference this morning, and it's... I don't know if that 1,000 was the number thrown out. I don't know if that's what's going to end up, but it's going to be, they said, bigger than the George Bush stimulation checks, which were 500 each. 500 a person.
Obama gave us a stimulation too, right?
No, the only stimulation he gave us was a prostate check.
Well, you could go back to Bloomberg when he spent $500 million...
Of his own money.
And then after he quit his campaign, you know, people were referencing, you know, how much money he spent. If he could have given every American citizen $1 million.
What?
Yeah. Based off of how much money he spent.
$500 million. There's only $380 million in the country.
Everybody could have got $1 million. How crazy is that?
And I guarantee if he would have gave all of us $1 million, I'd have voted for his ass.
Fuck yeah.
What a dumbass.
You want to buy an election?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
300K, 500K, shit.
Yeah.
A fucking million?
Million.
What the?
That's a strike. And so if you do get a $1,000 stimulus check, which just before I came over here, the Jake was reading on the news, and it said, we will get our money. The stimulus package will be passed tomorrow. You'll get your money within 2 weeks. Trump said, we want to get money in the American hands now to help with now. Not later. We're not doing a payroll tax thing that's going to only affect you 6 months down the road. We want to help people out now.
Well, that's a good thing.
No, it's a great thing.
Yeah, and then I know the Federal Reserve pumped a $1.5 trillion into the market just trying to keep it afloat.
Which really doesn't do much.
No, I mean, when you're, what, $11 trillion in debt?
Yeah.
That's insane.
I mean, and the market will rebound. It always will.
It'll come back. It always does. See, this is what I've been saying. You know, with everything taking a shit like it has been, the people with the most money are going to make an insane amount of money when this is over. Because they're going to swoop up everything.
It's like war. It's war.
Profiteering.
Yeah. And, you know, you can't blame them. I mean, when there's blood in the water.
So what do you do with your thought? Let's just say, hypothesize. In 2 weeks, you're going to get a $1,000 check to you.
I'm probably going to blow it. First off, I'm definitely going to visit. Now, is it per family or per
human? Per person.
Awesome.
Well, I think so per family it'll be 2,000.
Sweet. So I'd probably visit a local dispensary.
You would.
A fraction of it.
Yeah.
Well, I'm stressed fraction. Out. I'm stressed out.
Oh, you're really worried about the coronavirus, right? Right.
Well, the delivery services, you know.
What? So you're going to spend a G? You're going to spend a G?
No. I'm a fraction.
So what's a fraction?
A tenth of that.
So $100
So $100
Bullshit. You're going to spend $100
I don't.
Are you going to get a 100 milligram shake? Juice drink.
I'm going to mix it with my Jamba Juice. Okay. Or my blenders in the grass. But then I pretty much, you know what I do? I keep probably like 400 of it, and I give my wife 600 of it, and I'll figure out.
Your wife gets her own check.
I know, but she's going to want it too.
Oh, you're stupid.
I know. I'm trying to play it safe.
Sean?
You know, I've tossed the idea back and forth. I was thinking of, you know, maybe getting some Sitka waiters, but that seems like an impulse buy.
I got a better idea for you.
Huh?
You need another tattoo.
I do need a tattoo. Ooh,
ink would be good. Yeah.
It's either that or I start building an AR. I do not have an AR.
You can build an AR for way cheaper than that, too.
Yeah. So
you could get a tattoo and start the AR build. Because all you need is the lower, and you can get that for $50.
What's your next tattoo for?
I'm not sure yet. Probably my other ammogram that I need to get.
Oh, right.
Yeah. I'm going Friday.
Are you? Ooh, Did you got it set up?
Uh-huh.
You got it set up with the dude?
Yep.
He's a cool guy. I like him.
He's a good dude.
He comes in a lot and plays three-card poker.
We were talking the other night, and I'm like, you're still going to be open with all this coronavirus? He's like, oh, yeah, don't worry. It's sanitized. I'm like, oh, I could give two shits. I just want to make sure you're open. He's like, oh, good. I can give a shit about this crap either.
Well, tattoo shops and piercing shops tend to be one of the – they don't look it, but they're one of the most sterile places you could be. I mean,
absolutely.
With all the needles and piercing equipment and tattoo equipment, that shit's sterile.
I'm just going to be bummed. I'm hoping Hoagie's my favorite spot to eat in Pismo. Have you ever eaten at Hoagie's?
Is it a good sandwich shop?
Okay, dude. They have giant wraps. They have a Pismo wrap, and it's tri-tip, jack cheese, guacamole, barbecue sauce, french fries, all together. They've got like eight different wraps.
That's like a food truck.
Dude, it's huge. And I always stop and get it before I get a tattoo and eat half of it so you have a good meal before you're going to sit for 4 or 5 hours because they say you're supposed to eat a good meal before you sit.
See, I can't do that because I'd have to shit like midway through. Yeah.
So are you getting like a pickleball commemorative tattoo?
No. I've already got the pickleballs crossed on my back. That's, oh, nice. Yeah, yeah. And it says Jake and then pickleball champ below it.
And in case you forgot your name.
No, I'm going to get the Yodokai family tree.
Nice.
Yeah.
How big is that going to be?
It's going to be my whole left forearm and probably wrap the whole forearm. Hmm. Wrap around. Tribute to my grandmother.
There you go.
So,
that'd be nice.
Full color as always.
Yeah, you're a full color kind of guy.
I am a full color kind of guy.
Black and gray does not suit you.
No, I think the whiter you are, even though I'm mixed with so many different ethnicities, the Irish and the German have really taken over in my complexity. And the wrinkles and the sunspots really fuck white people as they get older. So you might as well make your arms look like melted Skittles instead of sunspots.
Yeah. Right. And then when you get really old, liver spots.
Yeah, liver spots. Well, I might get those about 55, 60.
You think so?
Yeah.
Oof, I probably already have them. But talking about black and silver, we've got a couple guys in the NFL going to be wearing black and silver this year.
Oh, segue.
Dynamite dropping. Segue Sally.
Marcus Mariota and Jason Witten going to Las Vegas.
So here's my take.
Okay.
Mariota, it's a good pickup. I mean,
I agree.
Derek Carr's dog shit, and I don't care who fucking says otherwise. He's dog shit.
And that just showed that the Raiders weren't going to make the run for Tom.
No, which is stupid.
Right. They should have.
They should have. I mean, why wouldn't you? New place, new fucking fan. But
that's how you get.
You want to put sales. Fucking fans in the stands because you got all these people from California whining about their season tickets. Oh, I've been going for so long, this and that.
You don't want them.
Yeah, and every Sir 13 guy's not going to drive over there. Mm-hmm.
And I think
that's good.
I think on principle alone, to not do it to the Raider fans, they let Tom Brady go because the Tuck rule. There's still a lot of butthurt feelings out
I
there.
I think so. Yeah,
with the Tuck rule, and oh, we would have won.
I'll tell you what.
And who was the coach of the Raiders when the Tuck rule happened? Oh, John Gruden.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe that's I see how well it came for a second. But talking about people with
Jason,
a player from a rival team. Go ahead, though.
Jason Witten was the stupidest fucking pickup in the world. Why do you pick Witten up when you have Waller?
And then what's the other guy's name? The white cat.
They got the white cat with the long hair, right?
And he's the guy that scores all the touchdowns.
And here's the thing. It's like, what is Witten going to give you? You want to go a W
in Vegas? Vegas.
But I don't know if he's going to translate with those guys. He's
like a 17-year veteran.
The only reason why he translated back with the Cowboys because those guys knew him.
They knew him. They that's his locker room. The owners know him.
Dude, Jason Witten got the same surgery fucking LeBron did, got hair to make himself look younger, and he's still...
He looked good with the shaved head. He looked mean.
He's done.
Like Brian Urlacher. Brian Urlacher had looked good with the shaved head, and now he's got the hair surgery.
Does he? I haven't seen Brian Urlacher.
He rocks hair now. Yeah, it's not that great.
Yeah. I mean, so you were saying rival
teams? Oh, rival teams, though, but I was talking about, you know, being on the, you know, being a Niner fan when Richard Sherman came through these last couple years. And then again, Brett Favre going to Minnesota. Those teams accepted those players.
Yeah, but they were still good.
They were valuable.
Dude, Richard Sherman, you know, he's not what he was, but he's still a starting cornerback in the NFL. Right.
He's better than the other guy you got.
Brett. Right. I mean, Jason Witten is not better than Waller. And he's
your third tight end.
Yeah, it's like, I don't get the move.
What they were saying on whoever's fucking sports show this morning was like, they're like, oh, every O-line coach is going to be juiced. I'm like, you got to be more than that to be your third tight end.
Dude, he's not fast enough anymore.
He runs the same route.
He's going to run
for Tony, for Dak.
He's going to get you a good 6 to 8 yard route.
And he's wide open is because the defensive coordinator is telling him, like, don't worry about Jason. If he catches a 10-yard out, gets the first time, okay. They're not hitting home runs.
Yeah,
and I'm not a huge Witten fan. I'll be honest. I think he benefited from being
the only guy.
And maybe with Tony Robo, pseudo-boyfriends. I don't know. I'm non-binary, so I'm not here to judge.
I question it.
And then he became Dak's favorite. Remember, Dez Bryant used to get pissed because Dak was throwing to the white boy instead of him. And that was well documented, those beefs.
Yeah.
So what the fuck does Witten give you?
I don't know how it works. Locker room maturity.
If Derek Carr's a quarterback, he gives them another check down option because that's about all. You should have went after
Diggs. Yeah. You needed a receiver.
Huge miss.
And Diggs, I think Josh Allen's stock just went up huge.
They got him a legit number one. I mean, not top tier number one, but like back half number one.
Top 10.
Yeah, so that's going to help that offense with the run game they got.
And they've got some other good young receivers. Yeah. John Brown? Yeah. Right? And
Zay Jones. And, you know, they got some guys. The running game's good. They got a good defense. And now they don't have to worry about Tom Brady and AFC East. I mean,
the Bills are the front runner in the East.
The Dolphins have spent a shit ton of money on defense this year.
I get it, but they're putting all their eggs into now their offense is going to be draft.
Yes.
Right? So now you're going to have that many more rookies that you're going to have to try and mesh together and a bunch of free agents. What's the unity? What's the locker room look like to get everyone on the same page? Who's the
quarterback? Is it still Fitzmagic?
Who knows? And then do they just become a poor man's version of the Browns? Bring all these big names in, and they can't mesh, and young pick. I don't see the Dolphins. If they draft correctly, I think in 3 years they'll be good.
You take a year or two to rebuild. When you become this young, you get rid of so much, and your whole offense, is youth.
I'm a big Josh Allen fan, so I think that the Bills are the front runner in the East.
Here's the thing that we haven't mentioned yet. Tom Brady went to the fucking Buccaneers.
Right.
My team. And correct me if I'm wrong. I mean, I've talked to some people about it already. They're not convinced that it's a good move for him. He's got two standout young wide receivers. He's got Chris Godwin and Mike Evans. And then they got a good tight end. They got a solid run game. It's good enough for the... For the NFC South, it's good enough.
How's the line play?
The O-line's not bad.
Okay.
The O-line's not bad. What kills them is turnovers. When you got a quarterback averaging 25 interceptions a year and five of those are going back for scores, what do you throw, 7 pick sixes this year?
Yeah, but he did have a lot of touchdowns.
It was
3 touchdowns, 1 pick, or...
He averaged like 2 to 2.5 turnovers a game.
Yeah. And you got to count his fumbles.
Yeah.
I had him in one of my fantasy leagues.
No.
He'd get you 32 points.
He should have got you 42.
Exactly.
Yeah.
He was a nightmare.
So, and then they got a young defense, number one against the run. I mean,
I think it's a good. I think Brady was in a. It's a decent.
It's like spot. A lateral move for him. It's not. It's not a. It's not a
I don't better see him move. Winning the Super Bowl.
Do I think the, where do I think the best spot he could have went to? In my opinion, I thought it was the Raiders, and then if the Raiders went hard on a receiver, they could have got a receiver.
I thought that was good too, and then
and the Titans.
Yeah,
you didn't think Indianapolis?
No, no, that's a terrible move for him.
Bad move
for him. It's a good move for Phillip Rivers because Phillip Rivers is used to working with dog shit.
Yeah.
You know, he's had one guy like his entire career.
If he went to the Titans, he went. I think the reason he probably didn't go to the Titans because it's the Patriots 2.0.
Yeah.
Or what, you know, 1.5.
Right. And he's going to be coached by his ex-teammate.
And then, which would have been good for him because he would have had control.
Now you think the Raider thing would have been a good option, though, even though they passed
the. I think it would have been a great option because with him, the Raiders are in the playoffs. Are they a Super Bowl contender? I don't know.
But they got the talent.
They got the contenders, Chiefs.
And they do have draft picks this year.
Yeah, they got a lot of draft picks.
Now, for me, just a little bit, when I heard he's going to the Bucs, I was like, maybe he wants the warmer weather, and he's not too serious about winning the Super Bowl. It's, again, like you were kind of mentioning, like a lateral move. It's not he's just going to be happy and kind of play out his years? Or do you think he really thinks he's going to win
the Super Bowl? No. I think this move, for him, it's finally about money.
Yep.
He has been so...
He's always taking one for the team.
He's always taking less money to keep people around.
People are like, oh, he makes tons of money on endorsements. I'm like, dude, he's had like an UGG campaign and make like the weakest Under Armour campaign. Yeah,
he's made money on endorsements. Don't get us wrong.
But not Nike money.
And
not...
the dude is well off. Mm-hmm. He's fine, and he's married a supermodel who's worth, you know, $100 million
equally
as well.
Equal to him.
Yes, I think Sean's right. I think it's a money ego thing, and I don't think there's anything wrong with it. I think
he deserves it. If anybody deserves it, he does.
Tom does. And I think he did make a move to a team that has offensive weapons that he hasn't had. He's lived by Gronkowski.
Yeah. And then the 1 year with Moss. But, I mean, look at what he's got to throw to. I mean, holy shit.
You got Evans and Godwin, and there's other guys as well.
They're actually over 6 foot.
Yeah.
Dude, Mike Evans, up until last year, Mike Evans was a top 3-4 wide receiver.
One of my favorite physical receivers, catches the ball, great with yak.
The thing I don't like about how they use Evans is they always put him wide out. They don't ever put him in the slot. Yep. I mean, give him a matchup problem.
I think if we believe the rumors that one of Tom's stipulations was... He wanted control over the offense, like play calling and
if Arian's smart, which he's a very good coach, I mean, I think he does that. Why would you not let a guy like that run it?
A guy that in the Patriots, let's be honest, everyone's like, oh, Josh Brown or Josh
McDaniels.
He's a great offensive coordinator.
I got it.
No, he's not a great offensive coordinator.
He's throwing some options out there, and Tom's telling him what he's going to do.
Tom Brady called that offense.
Yeah.
That's why he stayed there for so
That's
long.
That's why when they had those huge fights, like, what was it, 3-4 years ago?
Yeah.
It's because Tom's right, and Tom's going to get his way. At the end of the day, shut up, or you're going to piss off Tom.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
That's why.
Drop your plays. Call him if you want to call him, but.
Here, Tom, you can run this if you want.
Yeah. Me and Julian, I just looked at him. We already changed the play.
Now, does Julian Edelman, is he a free agent?
No, I think he's still under contract.
Oh, okay.
But
how bad did the Patriots
become this year? I could see Julian Edelman following him.
Oh, yeah.
If the Buccaneers get Julian Edelman as the number 3, the slot,
watch the fuck out.
Because you got Godwin and you got Evans. You go ahead, double Evans.
Speed, size, and freaking
a slot receiver. You could play the best defense. Look what the Cardinals are going to do this year.
Oh, we haven't even talked about that yet.
So that's what the Cardinals are going to do because Larry Fitzgerald
is still
good. He is not a number 1.
You put him in the slot,
and he plays tight. He's your tight end almost.
There you go. He's your flex tight end. Now you have Kirk, and then you put in DeAndre Hopkins, dude,
with a mobile quarterback.
And they're going to draft more with a line.
They have to.
That's all they got to do.
How bad is Houston going to drop off? How mad are you if you're a Houston fan?
You should be fucking livid. You should be jumping ship. Because
Deshaun Watson is pissed.
How do you let go of the best receiver in the game?
Yeah.
Elise mentioned it to me this morning because she gets ESPN updates and she's like, oh, she's like, they let him go. I'm like, to Arizona? I'm like, Houston fans are just... How do you do that?
Now,
how do you get rid of the best receiver? I'm like, my babe, that's the guy who dropped no balls 2 years ago. Two years in a row? He didn't drop one last year either?
How good is the NFC West now?
Hardest division in football.
Right? Because you got the Cardinals, the Niners, Seahawks. Rams and Seahawks.
Rams. Yeah.
The Rams are the weak link during the Super Bowl 2 years ago?
No, I think the Seahawks are the weak link.
Seahawks are the weakest. If Chris Carson doesn't come back healthy, they're in trouble. Yeah. And it showed.
The Rams will be fine.
Watch after week six. They always come back strong, too.
Dude, I'm telling you.
Russell's still getting snaps.
It's still the best division in football.
Mm-hmm. It went from the shittiest 5 years ago to now the best. I mean, the AFC East, just, it's wide open now. It's up for the taking.
And we know the AFC East has always been the Patriots.
It's always been the Patriots. Who is going to take over for them now? Josh McCown? I mean,
yeah.
Who the fuck they got? They're going to draft a guy?
A rookie?
Are they going to fucking pick up a free agent? I mean, holy shit.
Where are the Patriots going to be? Are they going to make playoffs next year?
And does Belichick keep coaching?
I don't know. That's a very good question.
Or does he keep coaching for the Patriots?
Oh, no.
I don't think he goes anywhere after New England.
He's always been in, like, that part of the nation. He can't go anywhere else.
Oh, yeah. No, he was in Cleveland.
New York and
Cleveland's in Midwest. Ohio, dude.
Okay, I'll give you that.
Come on.
But still, you know what
I mean? Come on, geography guy.
Only Morgan Hill.
Oh, okay. Oh,
only sorry. Morgan Hill.
East Dunn Street.
Once I get, you know, east of the 101, I'm kind of lost.
I hear you. Most people are.
Right, but so Arizona. They're picking up D-Hop. We do mention him. You're losing Daniel Johnson.
David Johnson. They don't need David Johnson.
They kept Kenyon Drake.
Kenyon Drake, was when there he any came trades in. Trades
well, other got, than that, or draft picks for I, that, was it straight across?
No, it was no, David think, Johnson.
Like a second or a second
round pick. A win for Arizona.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you didn't lose anything.
Well, what that tells me is, because DeAndre Hopkins was going to be a free agent of the year after this year, what that tells me was he wasn't staying.
Yeah.
And they knew he wasn't staying.
He voiced it.
So they got what they could. They thought they could have got. They obviously didn't try too hard, or maybe they did. I don't know.
I think their biggest need was running back. I mean, offensively, running back was their.
But I like David Johnson.
I don't. If he could ever return to form from his second year, I mean, look out. That's dangerous. But it's like, who are they throwing the ball to?
Now you don't have any. I mean, you have Dunn.
Fucking
or not Dunn, what's his name?
Yeah,
Fuller the fifth.
Will Fuller, you know, hurt six games a year, so it's like you're losing the guy that played every fucking game, never dropped a ball, like 120 receptions, 1200 yards, 10 touchdowns. I mean,
dude, it's the equivalent of the Rams getting rid of fucking the running back,
Todd Gurley.
What? Yeah. Your best player.
Yeah.
Like you don't do it. I don't get it. But the other thing we haven't talked about is Phillip Rivers makes another lateral move from.
I actually think it's a good move for him.
No, I don't, but it's still the Colts are the Colts.
Look, if I was Phillip Rivers and I'm in LA, San Diego, whatever, I really don't leave. I don't leave. For Indianapolis?
No, because he's.
Yeah, are you going to get paid not that much more?
Well,
you're broken already.
No, think about it.
He did not, like, physically.
Think about it.
He's playing indoors.
He's playing indoors.
That's the only positive.
Half of his games, at least half.
TY?
Because he's the RCA Dome. Is it still the RCA Dome?
Yeah.
RCA Dome.
Lucas Oil.
Houston plays inside.
He's going to have some indoor games.
I mean, he's going to have to play in Tennessee.
Well, it's probably cheaper for all. You know what the real reason is?
Jacksonville.
The nine kids he's got to fucking.
Yeah, he needs to spend nine kids in
fucking California.
Well, and the good thing is it's, you know, it's you're more in the Midwest where they're more conservative values and they're going to. They're not going to
fit right in.
Look down on him having another 18 kids.
We're getting a good Christian coming in.
That's
what's happening.
But don't get me wrong. I mean, people bag on Phillip Rivers, but the dude can fucking play.
I hate Phillip Rivers.
Everybody hates him. But he can fucking play.
Yeah.
I mean, he throws the ball fucking weird, but he's fucking good.
So did you see Cam Newton's tweet today?
Oh, yeah. I didn't ask for that. You know?
I'm kind of okay with the tweet. It's like the Panthers made it seem like
he wanted it.
And he's like, I like the tweet. He's like, I love Carolina. I love the fans. I love the team. But I didn't ask for this. Don't act like I did. So I mean, they're obviously the Cam Newton show has sailed. Where does Cam go? Does he go to the Patriots?
Cam, yeah, I'll take a little bite. To me, Cam doesn't go to the Patriots. He doesn't fit what they need. I mean, I think he's better than what they got, but I don't think he fits the system because he can't throw the ball.
What do you think about him following Rivera to Washington?
Not with Haskins.
Yeah, Haskins is a younger version of Cam.
Yeah.
That can't run.
Yeah. I mean, to me, Cam, if Cam lands anywhere, he's lucky. I mean, just look at the guy.
Can he go to New England?
That, well, I just said that.
We just, talked about it.
I was getting nice.
Yeah. No, can't does not fit New England. If they do pick him up, good for them. I mean, I don't know how that works out with McDaniel and...
Does Cam go to the Chargers?
That might work. That might work. I mean, it's so a lax really area. Who's fighting
for Burrow, though? The rookie.
Where's he going to go? Before we go to Burrow, what if Cleveland brings in Cam Newton? Baker Mayfield didn't do shit last year.
I don't think he's trash. I think...
They're treating him like trash. Talking about him like
sophomore
trash.
Slump.
Yeah, but dude...
With those weapons...
With Odell and...
You should not have had a slump with those receiving weapons.
Do you think some of that was distraction? Do you think those receiving weapons
there was a lot of reading of their own headlines and not a lot of performance because their defense did not play well.
Yeah, I think that's the big part of the performance. But I think that with Mayfield, when you miss a freaking 15-yard crossing route 3 yards high every game, that's on the quarterback.
Yeah.
That's shit that you just do. And he was a beaten pony at the end of the season.
So after the head coaching issue they had, after the freaking Myles Garrett issue, he had to go through all that distraction. You do have weapons.
No, there was the Odell distraction.
Right.
I mean, for a young kid, that's a lot to weigh on you. I mean, your number one weapon is in the media.
All these things happening and you have a bad season, okay. It's like I understand, you're a second-year quarterback.
I know. I'm just I'm playing devil's advocate because the NFL is not, you know, it's what have you done for me now?
Yeah, right. Oh, for sure.
But is Odell going to stay with Brown?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's not going anywhere.
He's not going anywhere. Okay. Are you kidding me? Him and Jarvis Landry have
Jarvis is almost the older brother in that situation.
They're the epitome of bromance.
You say brother as in spouse, right? That's what you meant?
You mean like...
Because they were roommates at LSU.
Or a top, bottom?
No, I think they're both twinks. I think it's something they just switch off on. Who the top and who the bottom is. I think it just depends on the day.
You know, we did miss a lot. What about how much did Odell get fined for slapping the cop in the butt after the LSU championship game? Was it like half a mil?
He should have went to jail.
Yeah. I mean, he was so hammered.
So drunk.
And then
he's handing out cash. It's like
NCAA violation.
What are you doing?
They were done playing. They were done playing, so I guess it wasn't. There was like a loophole.
Yeah, no, I know.
But I mean, fuck. Could you look any worse? All right, so... Back to where you were going with Joe Burrow, I'm going to say, like, before we talk about where he goes and what he does, that motherfucker is so, like, gangster, keeping it
legit. I like that dude.
I like the way he handles himself, like, when he was at the Combine. Oh, I really, you know, I'm way behind all these guys. These guys have had, like, an extra month of practice.
I was
busy winning a national championship. You know, the swag this fucking guy has.
The cigar pose?
The smoke and the cigar.
Yeah. I mean, he is swagged to the fucking max.
He's a leader. That's a guy you want in your locker room.
Yeah. But is he going to produce?
It's the same kind of leadership Baker has.
No.
Baker was more...
He's a rah-rah guy.
Rah-rah guy.
Look at the egos.
Joe's a little more sit back.
No, Joe's a big dick guy. He's like, motherfucker. Well, okay, let's play.
Just look at the difference in egos that each guy had to maintain. Baker coming from Oklahoma. Oklahoma is a powerhouse in itself in the Big 12, but they're not on that national level every year. LSU's got every swing and dick going there. They're top five in recruiting every year. They're pumping out fucking first round draft picks. You know the egos in that locker room are huge. Who's gonna lead that guy? That right. Team? You need a motherfucker throwing that dong out. Fucking be like, look, motherfuckers, this is me. I'm gonna lead this team, and you're gonna fucking.
Oh, you
me.
Got so a Ocho? I got a DS.
So do you think he could do that in the NFL?
No,
not right away.
I don't think he could try it, but now he's working with men, and to me, that's a little bit different.
But here's the thing: he is a man. He's 25. Yeah, he's 25.
Look, this is the difference. Look at what I'm saying. When you're saying like, oh. Baker is a hoorah guy or a rah-rah guy, right?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe that doesn't translate when you go to men. But big dick, casual, like, hey, I'm putting that shit on the table. Let's fucking win some games. Maybe that does translate.
He's already a dude. He's going to be older than most of his receivers.
Yeah.
So who has the first pick?
Oh, shit.
Cincinnati?
Yeah.
Oh, it's Cincinnati. So he's going to be a Bengal.
That's true. They ain't going to let go of him.
Oh, no, that's right, because he had said... He had already tweeted AJ Green
that if they didn't keep him,
then I ain't going. Like he had said, like Bengals, I ain't coming if you don't keep AJ.
I want to know who's his agent.
Probably Rosenhaus.
Bro? Who do you pick as
well, your here's the thing. Rosenhaus. I don't think it fucking matters. It's obvious he knows how to play the game. He's not a dumb young kid.
No.
You know, everything's calculated.
Oh, for sure.
Everything he does, he's a dude that's read The Art of War.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Do you know what I'm saying? Yeah. He's like a young coach. He's a guy that kind of gets it. I'm excited to see what he does. I think I'm going to be a fan of his because I just kind of like listening to his post-game conferences.
I can gravitate the way he plays. He plays with a lot of fire. He's got a good arm. I mean, dude, the shit about his hands was fucking hilarious.
Hilarious. Yeah. That was the funniest new stat of the whole combine.
Hand size is not a new thing. Everybody fucking made a big deal about it this year. It's not a new
thing.
It's
just because it got blown up because of him. Because
he's got small hands. It looks like my football career is over because I got small hands. And then everybody's inserting the Burger King commercial with the guy with the small hands and the double cheeseburger.
Yeah. But, the best time, yeah.
But it's like the dude can play football. Now, is he going to be successful? I don't think out the gate he is. I think if he grinds and gets to work, it's going to be a matter of how he gets to work, you know, how he carries himself as that professional. You know, you look at the great quarterbacks, they're professional, they're articulate, and, you know, the off-season work is what the proof is.
Yeah,
you know?
I think he'll have to cut down some of his brashness.
Just a bit.
There's only been a couple of quarterbacks that have ever been able to be successful and brash, and it started with Joe Namath.
Yeah.
He was really the one that was able to do it.
Right. And he came in, drafted into New York, owning that shit.
I mean, come on. When you're smoking a cigarette and wearing a fur coat and banging Hollywood actresses nonstop and partying.
You know how to play the game.
He also lived in that era when it was acceptable.
Fur coats, again, big dick, hanging with the brothers, doing all kinds of shit. Just like,
what quarterback has been successful since Joe Namath with that brashness
from the rookie year?
I wouldn't even say rookie year, but what
man?
There you go. I think
that's the McMahon. The only thing I was thinking about was McMahon because he got
the only other guy I can think
of. And McMahon was not.
He wasn't good.
He wasn't good.
No, he wasn't.
What McMahon was the perfect quarterback for the Chicago Bears at that time, playing for Mike Ditka, that wanted a guy that had that fucking mentality.
Exactly.
Yeah, because I remember the only story I remember when McMahon got drafted is that he, from Provo, Utah to Chicago, maybe he was at the draft. I don't know if it was New York or not. But anyways, he flies into Chicago, and he cracks a beer, and he sits up there and does his press conference.
Yeah.
So that's kind of like one of those.
Oh, and that was McMahon. And he, first guy with the earring, quarterback, white quarterback.
Sunglasses, with headband.
Yeah, and he, since then, has said, I always wore sunglasses because I always had a concussion. He's like, I had to always play with concussions. I played for Mike Ditka.
Maybe that's what I heard. It was different. He has an eye issue. He got stabbed in the brother in a pencil. He got stabbed by his brother in the eye with a pencil.
Fuck, alliteration.
Hey, I'm getting too excited here. It's my ESL skills are coming in right now. Help me finish this. but no, he got stabbed in the eye. He's got a funky eye.
Yeah, no, I know.
So that was, I don't know which one it was.
But and
it
one
was,
of his,
was a story
and one of those 30 for 30s, he said, I always had a concussion, so I wore glasses. It could have been for.
All right. So draft order. Let's see. Cincinnati Bengals, Redskins, Detroit Lions, the G-Men, Miami Dolphins, Chargers, Panthers, and Cardinals. There's only a couple spots there for Joe Burrow to go.
Oh, the Bengals are going to draft him.
Yeah.
They didn't re-sign Dalton, did they?
Not sure on that. I think he might still be under contract.
But it's Andy Dalton.
Dude, the red rifle is underwhelming, to say the least.
I mean, come on. That experiment went long enough there. He had some good years, but they could never win a playoff game.
He's good until it counts.
Yeah.
Now, if you're Joe Burrow and you say, you know, maybe you text AJ Green thinking that he's going to stay there, but is AJ Green going to even be that
good? AJ Green got franchise tagged. He's going to stay.
Oh, but still, is he that good?
No.
AJ's not that good. He's a number two guy.
Right.
They need a home run hitter at number one. They don't have it. They got a couple of good running backs.
The Bengals are three drafts away from being good. Or I shouldn't say good. Significant viable in the playoff game, right? I just don't see it happening.
They're still the bottom feeder of the AFC North.
They're the second best team in Ohio. And when the Browns are better than you,
oh yeah, you got problems. I mean, Marvin Lewis played that game a long time. You know, they were the best team in Ohio, but they fucking couldn't get over the hump.
Yeah.
You know, they were doing it. It was basically the AJ Green show. It's the only reason they won.
So who's the second best quarterback going to be? Who's the next quarterback drafted after?
In my opinion, Herbert.
Yeah. From Oregon.
The Oregon kid.
He's got a cannon.
The kid's got a cannon. He can move a little bit. I mean,
I'm hoping the Lions take him.
Stafford has run a good race, but they need to plan for the future.
His back's done.
He's injured.
Dude, he gets fucked up every year. I mean, he's running for his life. He gets a shit beat out of him.
But see, last year they had a decent line. They had a lot of things in place last year to make a run to be like...
They could have been good. As soon as he went out, like, they were doing really good until he got hurt. And then it just plummeted.
They have a decent defense. And with Matt Patricia, I think that's what's helping it. But that team revolved around him. So if he can play this year, I think that's a good position for Herbert to come into to play behind Stafford for a year.
Learn the game, you know, learn how to be a pro, this and that. Because Stafford's still on his rookie contract, isn't he?
Is he really?
No, he's not. No.
Because his rookie contract was fucking steep. He got like 60 guaranteed. Sam Bradford was the last one.
And Cam Newton.
I thought it was Sam Bradford.
Okay. Oh, you're right. No, you're right.
You got the last big
like contract. $70 million.
Stafford plays hurt
all the time.
That dude. That,
you could replay that highlight of him taking that shot, the timeout getting called,
and running him down, like getting carried to the sideline, smelling salts, you name it, and then going back in the game.
Let's go. He's a Georgia boy, man.
Yeah,
one of the best moments in football, I think.
So how about, speaking of Georgia boy,
Jake Fromm.
I mean, QB1 Jake Fromm. I think we all like him. It's so sad
because I like the kid. I like his leadership. I like the way he plays the game. I mean, he's a good dude.
Yeah.
He's a guy you want on your team, but he's not a starter.
I think he's going to turn into a journeyman quarterback.
He's going to be a Matt Leinart.
He's going to be in the league for 15 years.
Yeah. He's not going to start a whole lot. Because, dude, watching him throw the ball and fucking the combine, did you watch combine at all? Like, it was so underwhelming. Like, his arm was weak. He's throwing fucking rainbows to these fucking guys flying 4-4.
Well, the worst was the freaking Hawaii quarterback.
Oh, dude. Oh, my God. So bad.
He couldn't even hit 10-yard outs on a break.
Who was the tight end that got drilled in the face? Oh, the UCF tight end.
Yeah.
Dude, when you're, like, the meme of the fucking combine, that's got to suck.
Yeah.
Yeah, speaking of the combine, how about it doesn't fucking mean shit, but the punter that reps 225
He did it more, like, I want to say he was in the upper 25% of the entire combine.
He beat every tight end and every wide receiver.
I don't understand. How are these guys not strong?
Yeah.
How does that happen?
Because you don't get, when you say tight ends now and you look at the group, they don't look like tight ends did like 15 years ago.
They're still 6'4", 250.
Not 250. They're like...
No, there's dudes. There's still no, they're not 220. Dude, they're 6'4", 240 to 250.
You can't be 6'4" and 220.
You're playing wide receiver.
You know what it is? Think about this. These guys are only been playing for 3 years in college and they're going to the NFL.
They're still young.
No.
They're still 20.
These motherfuckers have spent their off seasons playing club 7-on-7 instead of lifting.
Oh.
That's what it's turned into.
Dude, when you get a punter outlifting like a third of the linebacking core? That's pathetic.
Who was the punter for the Giants that was slipped up?
He was so roided out.
There were some jacked punters.
Where's Oscar Roddy when we need him?
Yeah.
Exactly. You know, I'm going to text Oscar.
Dude. But it's pathetic.
But don't you think that's why it is? These seven-on-seven things?
I completely agree with that.
Because our generation or even the generation after, people that are in their late 20s, even mid-20s, you spent your offseason lifting.
Yeah.
This guy's coaching 7-on-7 football.
Oh, shit. You're coaching that club.
He went to my hometown, Morgan Hill.
What a nice facility.
My one complaint is the location of the restrooms. They're not centrally located. No. All the way to one fucking side.
It used to be only grass, and it wasn't. There was no bathroom piping.
I was just up in Morgan Hill again. I don't know if it was the same time. No, it was a pickleball meeting. I'm on a coalition here. And I ate at a great seafood restaurant in Morgan Hill.
Oh.
It was called Sandy's by the Beach, I think. Or Rosie's by the Beach.
Yeah, that's, you could draw, you know, they got the paper crayons.
It was actually paper crayons. It was actually really good. And they had Breakers bourbon.
Oh.
And I had a Breakers Old Fashioned.
How was it made?
Good, and with a single ice cube.
Was there a small Mexican waiter busboy?
Tough to tell. They all look Mexican.
I know, but I used to coach one of them. He works there, so Artie.
No, it was really good. I had some ahi tacos.
Rosie's is awesome. It's a good place to go. Yeah. And they have a cool little bar off to the side.
Yeah, it was a really cool spot.
Green Hill's got a handful of cool little bars now.
And that Rosie's is right downtown.
Right downtown. There's a...
What's a breakfast spot right downtown where we went?
Right downtown?
Yeah.
Just for breakfast. Or just breakfast.
That's where we went the second day. Time. No, because we went to San Martin Cafe first.
San Martin, but we also go to... my number one spot. What is it called? Betsy's Cafe. Betsy's is by the bowling alley. Is the bowling alley?
Betsy's came highly recommended.
Betsy's is like the truth.
I don't think we ate there because remember we sat with your parents. It was in the brown building. I want to say it was just breakfast.
Just breakfast for sure.
Yeah.
I think when the first time or second time we went there with Echo Hoff, we went for sure. Yeah. I remember we took a friend one time and he just drank way too much. But remember he took the creamer. In the freaking little metal tin creamer cans, and he was just like being a fool with it, like use it all, calling over the waitress, and my parents came, and you were so embarrassed.
And this was breakfast?
This was breakfast.
Yeah. And he was fucked up already?
Still fucked up.
Oh, yeah. I was super embarrassed.
Hey, this cat.
He fell over.
And this was Echo Hoff?
This is the night before or the night of that same day. Dude. Right? So my driveway is in a small incline. The car pulls uphill, right? And he's standing there. My parents come, and I don't know if the lights. Use something for him, but the lights switch off on him. He's standing straight up, and he's facing uphill, and he's falling backwards downhill, bro.
Oh,
and
I'm,
there was no bend in his hips.
It was
no,
like
my parents are pulling in, sweetheart parents, super.
And innocent. He just, I'm like,
on the back of his head, and me and Sean are so pissed. Only one other time have we picked up a human like this.
Yeah.
Like, just scoop him up. Like, what? We're more pissed than worried about him.
It's like, dude, what are you fucking doing?
But that's how he treated the weekend in Morgan Hill with my parents.
He was
like, I'm getting hammered.
I was thoroughly surprised at the little downtown. It is quaint.
It's popping.
Yeah, it's cool.
Sinaloa Cafe. Emanate. You know, John Gruden went into our little hole in the wall.
Well, that's awesome.
It's like the little 12-stool bar in Morgan Hill.
But I thought it was pretty cool looking. Like, there's like lights strung across. It's like, it looks like kind of how Solving can get, like, you know, the right. Main drag.
It's a really cool place. And
I mean, it does not look like Lompoc.
Since I've moved here, it's grown exponentially. Yeah. Sean is just pouring fire into our cups right now.
That was a heavy pour. It just kind of went,
can I get some more ice in there? Yeah, I got to cool that off.
Well, first of all, so we are back in the game. Obviously, we haven't...
Oh, whiskey time.
Oh, yeah.
Whiskey time. We're drinking George Jickel Tennessee Sour Mash Whiskey, 12-year. It's pretty money. I've had this in the...
Who'd
in
you
the
steal wings. That from?
Well, it was a gift is what the joke is, Sean. It's not that I stole it. Obviously, I'm not buying a bottle.
No, God, no.
But I actually bought this for the clinic.
That you didn't bring.
I brought it. We didn't drink it. Yeah. Oh. We're just sometimes when you're in a mess like that, Jack Daniels just handles everybody well. And
you know, I'd like to give a shout out right now. A shout out. But okay. I'd like to give a shot as well. A shout out. That's the way that Jake speaks. I've been acclimating to this area since I've moved from Slo County. I've noticed I've been very big on the SYV resource and chat room on the Facebooks, the Book of Faces. Uh-huh. And I just want to give a good congratulations to the new high school athletic director, Ashley Quelo. She has done a great job. And she's got some shit, I hear, through the grapevine. I go to the cafes. I drink coffee with the locals.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, once in a while. Timers. I come down once a week from my hill on the mountain, from my yurt. And, you know, some people were talking that she doesn't like men and she doesn't like men's sports. And you know what?
She coaches football.
She is a class act and she's a football coach. She gets along with everyone. The kids love her. So I just want to give a public shout out to Ashley Quelo. I'd love to meet this young woman. I don't know if she's young or old. I've never seen her. I just read about her.
Hold my whistle would like to just announce that she is our athletic director of the year.
Oh, congratulations. Yeah,
she's been doing a great job. We support her in all her actions. Congratulations, Ashley Quelo. We think you're doing a great job. But let's talk about what she's doing.
Is she in the Maldives right now?
I don't think so.
Oh.
Yeah, I don't think so yet. Yeah, it might be. It could be rumor. Who knows?
But I think she's done a great job. Like, it's not an easy job.
Yeah.
And she's looking for all the athletes. You know.
She has been hit with a shitstorm this year.
She's had to do some of the tough things that athletic directors have to do. It's not like she's sitting on a whole bunch of winning programs that have great coaches.
But you know, she's doing. She's leading from the top. She is not letting people just skate by. She's holding everyone to a same standard of every sport.
You know what I like about it? It's like, oh, St. Inez is supposed to be a football, men's volleyball, girls soccer school. No, sports. And St. Inez, as a whole, is elevating because of Ashley Coelho.
Yep.
And that's, you know, from the bottom, coaches, players, parents are going to be better because of the experiences she's going to provide for the kids.
And she, I think we got to give her props just for working hand in hand and having to coach with Rekha. I mean, she's Jason Finley's right hand woman.
Yeah.
Not actually. So, did anyone see the Cabrillo game? The last.
No.
I was there.
Oh, you were there.
Epic meltdown.
Well, that was after like three season ending injuries, wasn't it?
Oh, it's, well, even after the first one, at halftime, she loses an all star girl. Our girl Q.
Quincy.
And bad injury. I heard she's doing okay now.
Yeah, she's back throwing shot put right now.
Good. Right?
Or was.
But,
oh, yeah.
So this is a series of, like, again, bad calls. Again, there's a call where there's a scramble for the ball. A coach has timeout. No one has the ball, but
the timeout's referee, granted.
The timeout's granted. Or there was no one saw who the ball was out on. The referee makes the decision. Kind of situation, and then at halftime, boom, you lose a big player on pretty much a tackle.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And Jason, Rekha's got his girls already going in, and she gave a little bit of lip, but before she knows it, everyone's already in the locker room. The court is cleared, right? And she's got like a quarter of the court left, and it's her, and I think Jake likes to make fun of bald referees.
Yes.
And so this guy's got a shiner on, bro.
Yeah.
I eventually might look like him in 3 to 4 years.
That much, really? That much time?
High gloss. 8 months.
High gloss. It's looking bad.
Yeah.
Right? High gloss. And she is giving...
She's digging on him.
The Bob Knight almost threw a chair.
She's giving him the business.
This guy. Like, no one's holding her back, but it looks like someone's holding her back. She's jumping up and pointing and, like, getting pulled towards the door. Great job. And the parents are like, hey, only the coach could do that. And I'm in the back yelling, and the athletic director. So, hey, but that's how passionate she is about the school, the sports programs, and that's how hard she's working. She's coaching 3 seasons.
Yep.
She's athletic director. She isn't teaching it anymore.
No,
but still,
she does tutoring, right?
No, tutoring, yes, and she's the testing coordinator.
Man, her office is always full,
and soon to be maybe, I don't know.
No announcements.
I can't announce it, but I would say that she's a baller. Kids love her.
I'll tell you what, and she is a champion for all the sports. She's trying to
get
the wrestling team a room. She's trying to do all the little things that we're supposed to have in San Ynez.
She,
for the sports
program. She pushes kids to support other sports, like go watch, you know, if you're a girls basketball player, go watch the boys team. If you're a, you know, a football player, go watch the water polo
program.
Team.
Supporting program.
Yeah, she's big. And she's been huge on, from what I hear, I talk to the people at the cafe I go to.
Yep.
Yeah, and have my morning coffee. I guess there's going to be a new turf field at the high school. They have to replace
Can't
it.
Can't wait.
She has been huge at getting that happening.
It's going to look fucking badass.
Sean, you know, I think you have an inside loop. Is there any inside tips or ideas?
Oh, it's going to... I'm just going to throw this out there. We have the most swag in the fucking county. You know, if we were...
The field we walk on, the shoes we wear, the socks that go inside of them, the pants, the pads... Oh,
if we were a private school, we'd be recruiting like a motherfucker. Right, we could be the Oregon of the Central
Coast. The Yoda Kai approves.
I'm going to need your opinion on some new swag, okay? I've seen them the last year and a half, maybe two. The thigh pads with the number or the team logo in it, what are your feelings on them?
In the thigh pads?
The thigh pads. They have thigh pads now. If you're number 12... They'll have a 12 on them, or if you're...
Wait, do you see that?
You could see it through the pant.
Oh, that's stupid.
That's 3D. Lame.
It's 3D.
That's lame.
That
both of you say it's lame. Okay, just wondering. I've seen that amount of, you know...
The Jake has coined a new term. That is so COVID.
Oh, my goodness.
So COVID.
My goodness. So any other big moves happening in the NFL? Nothing too big.
Not that I know of.
Nothing. Drafting.
Basketball's done.
I'm a little bummed because I'm a huge Lakers fan. I will say this. I've since the time I was here, we had a podcast with the boys from King's Barbershop, mm-hmm. our favorite barbershop. And we sat here, and Vic, right before he opened his new shop. And
Lawrence Tynes was the punter.
Yes,
Lawrence Tynes. So Vic and I made a bet after that podcast that the Lakers would have a better regular season record than the Clippers.
Right, and that bet can't be finished.
Well, no, that bet is finished. Lakers have a better regular season record.
So I made a bet with Vic that he tried to get me to pay up on like a month ago about where the Warriors would finish in terms of where the Lakers would finish. With the season unfinished, to me, that bet is void.
The season's finished, and I want my money. And the Lakers were going to be winning a national championship this year. And that was LeBron's
You mean a world championship?
World championship, national championship. It doesn't matter. It's a championship, and you get a ring, and we were going to win. And I still think they're coming back.
What are the chances?
There's an asterisk on the season.
Well, yeah, but here's the thing. They're going to come back. There's no way this is lasting till the end of June for the NBA.
You know what?
When do playoffs usually start?
The playoffs start in May, like the end of April.
May.
So it can still start for the NBA.
I think so. How many games have they played?
They're about 2/3 of the way done.
The Lakers are like 40-something and 13. 50.
Yeah.
Go for it. They've got like 25
games. What was the shortest season they've had? They've already had a season
shortened. You've had shortened seasons. Shorter seasons. That would the pro things will come back.
The thing
that sucks is like tournament. I've been a big fan of girls softball in NCAA.
Yeah.
And
the Oregon girls.
The Oregon girls. If you have not watched Jazz Sievers, and I think it's Haley, I can't remember her name, Cruz. Yeah. They have the best TikToks. They are hot. I mean, super hot. Blonde chicks. I mean, the whole Oregon softball team.
It's good looking.
They're freaking sevens, all of them and up. And they make the
nominees for the blowies?
Yes. Oh, and then when you watch these girls, these dainty little blonde chicks that are slim, and they just hit dingers.
Dingers.
Yep. And dogs.
When you're hot and you're winning, you're that much hotter.
And then a bunch of them are seniors.
Yeah.
And they were going to, they're the top. Well, I think they were number one.
They were number three. Number three. But
they're up in the run.
Dude, they're going to be
in the top six, right?
They were going to be in the College World Series. And, you know, the same could be said for the Oregon girls basketball team.
Yeah, exactly.
They got swag. Who's that blonde girl?
Well, Ionescu. Yes. I don't know her first name, but.
Yes.
The one thing that does make me happy, nobody deserves to eat a shit sandwich more than the NCAA. Fuck the NCAA. Yeah, I'm so glad they're losing all the revenue from the fucking tournament and everything.
I wish they could lose the revenue from the tournament, but we still have the tournament to watch.
First, remember, they were going to just have it be intimate family, and I was like, so what? The tournament's still happening.
Yeah. I was still happy about that. Okay.
But no tournament. It's like
no tournament sucks because right now
we should be doing bracket. We should be looking for round.
So right now, El Rancho just came out with their ad for tomorrow that starts, and it says the big tournament ad, and it's all like wings and stuff because it must have been populated a month ago. And your ad is about watching sports. There ain't a motherfucking sport to watch.
Do we do our own hold my whistle bracket for the people who don't have a bracket? And we could do a random one again.
I think we should do something. The hold my whistle. Bracket of randomness.
I concur.
I think we could figure out. And coronavirus will be something to see if it wins.
what do we call it? The case file?
Corona case file.
We'll get some people.
When you do know, and I think
I
this.
I heard.
Standard Paulo just talking over everybody.
Diesel Horse is clear of the coronavirus, so.
Diesel Horse got cleared. Yeah. He did get tested, I heard.
He was definitely positive on some other issues, but he's clear.
So, toot, here comes a Diesel, got the negative test results on the coronavirus. That's good to know. Right.
I'm scared if I get tested.
Why?
I work in a very, very...
You haven't worked. You showed up for two... Look at the one day I missed, maybe you showed up. But you've been to Colorado. Dude,
I was in Colorado. How was Colorado? It was awesome.
I'm pretty sure half of us are going to test positive.
Yeah.
Who cares? I'm not going to get tested.
No.
I'm not sick, man.
I'm not hurting.
No. Look,
the Foy fucking immune system it's top notch. Look, it fend off bird flu, swine flu, fucking SARS. Every 4 years,
whatever these come out. That I've been with, whatever they had, I didn't get.
Yeah, I mean,
I defended some real serious stuff.
The big thing is you beat herpes, you don't have HIV. What the fuck else, man? This isn't patient zero. We're not going to die from this shit. People are freaking out and just chill out.
No, okay, so let's talk about whatever. The whole world's kind of stressing on the nation, at least. The toilet paper thing.
Oh, my God, dude. Oh, my goodness. Are you shitting yourself to death?
I'm running into some of my good friends that are outdoorsmen, that are well-prepared, that have survival gear.
Oh, I live in a yurt off the grid.
Exactly. You're one of those friends.
Yeah.
You have to cut it. It's tough to survive. Why do people need so much toilet paper? I'm looking at like 6 rolls of toilet paper, looking at like, I'm good for my whole family.
Well, here's the thing.
For like a month.
You don't need toilet paper to shit.
That's what I'm saying.
There's a lot of other things you can do.
You know what people are doing? And thank God I got one, is we had the reusable diaper or the cloth diaper rinse toilet attachment.
Yeah, well, you know what the Jake does.
It's pretty much a fucking
bidet. Most of the time when the Jake shits, I shit before a shower. And I don't even wipe my ass because toilet paper gives me some nasty chemicals from that dye. I hate
watching this shit roll down my leg, though, and into the fucking...
No, you just take you got the nozzle in your shower.
I still watch it go down the drain.
Yeah, but it's a good feeling.
It's not too bad.
The one time that Jake was in... The Jake was in the Dominican Republic.
Were you in the DR?
I was in the Dominican.
Oh, how's the water?
Oh, it's phenomenal. Tasty. They had bidets in all the hotel rooms, and I am a bidet fan now.
Well,
I have never partaken.
I will say,
I'll tell you what, toilet paper and humidity aren't friends.
No, and once you bidet, you'll never go back. If you could install a bidet in your house, you will, because the freshness and the cleanness you feel, and there's no baboon butt. You don't feel like you're wiping your ass with a snow cone. If you got a messy one where you got to do like a 6 wiper.
Yeah.
Right? You know,
and that 6 wipe, 5th wipe shit, that hurts.
That hurts, right? And your butt's raw.
Even if you go wet wipe toilet paper.
I don't like wet wipes.
No, what you do is with the bidet, and then you get a warm, dried washcloth. It's dry, but it's in a warmer.
Oh, my God. Terry cloth?
Terry cloth.
Or bubble bowl.
And you dry your bunghole off with that. You are in a 6th or 7th heaven that you've never experienced before.
But you're in a tropical place, so you're not wearing any underwear.
Of course.
And you're losing if a little bit of brown ends up on your towel.
Well, we did install a bidet in the yurt. I'm going to have to say it, going to announce this now. We did install a bidet in the yurt.
You know, I've only been in high-end yurts. I've only been in one or two
of them. Well, our yurt is, it's an off-the-grid high-end.
Does it have a heated toilet seat?
No, we do not like the heated toilet seat.
They have that option for yurts.
That's a waste.
They know, no, not for the yurts, because yurts are in the outdoors. I'm telling you.
I understand. But we saved our wood burning for our water heater is a wood burning water heater. Our stove is wood burning what we cook off. We are off the grid. And in fact, last night we had goose for dinner. I had to kill one of our family geese. His name was Pillow, because he was going to be a down pillow.
He's a down pillow? Goose down?
Oh, boy. And we had some El Pastor goose tacos, and you know, down tasted just fine and tasty. And
it's a good name for a goose.
Yeah, you'd name him down. We did have a pig 1 year named Christmas. He was ready for a Christmas ham. Well, that's what we do at the Yodokai family. We raise our animals to eat,
and you name them accordingly.
Well, yeah,
I mean, after a holiday,
I think so. So no emotions are involved.
Zero emotion.
No, none. We had a Yom Kippur turkey. A lot of people don't have turkey for Yom.
You didn't have a brisket. Fucking Yom Kippur.
We had a
fucking turkey.
A turkey for Yom Kippur.
Paul, let's start talking.
I can't. This is where you're supposed to be rolling right now.
That was a good one.
It was hilarious.
Oh, man. It could be the entire bottle of Dickel that has been consumed in this show.
We did drink it. Yeah. It's been a while since I had some bourbon, though.
Yeah,
well, I've been doing a lot of beers.
We're all on house arrest.
I know.
What are you going to do?
I'm out of work. Sean's out of work. You're out of work.
Yeah, the pickleball community is fucked.
Yeah,
right,
you're
now.
You're off season right now.
My prayers and thoughts go out to all my pickleballers.
So there is I did mention that there's no excuse for us not to work out, but I'm finding excuses not to work out.
Well, the Jake has been working out, so you are welcome to join the Jake every day at 9 a.m.
Oof.
The Jake does weights for 45 and then a run.
I have never played pickleball.
We could actually, wow, well, we and could
or,
do this.
Or cornhole tournaments is all what I've heard. What
I think, well, there was darts thrown out.
I think we could contact somebody. I'm thinking our friend Ashley Quelo. I don't know her, but I think that you two do.
Right. I think we got enough
pool. I'm first name basis with her. She's my receivers coach.
We might be able to get into the gym since it's not being used and set up a little pickleball.
I am down for
it. I am an all-time back row guy.
And I think our good buddy Oscar Roddy, I've gotten to know that that crazy little Latino. He since the last time I was here, I had only met him once or twice, but we've had beers a couple of times.
Oh.
Yeah, and I've gotten to know that guy, and he's not a bad guy. He's a good little character.
He looks like he's got a decent pickleball game.
Yeah, he's not bad. He's not Jake, of course, but
he's athletic.
So something we're doing through the whole Corona issue is a pickle tourney. Pickleball tourney.
If we can swing it.
I definitely want to get some friends together, though. And I know I saw them mentioning, and I was watching ESPN, the Ocho. I love watching the cornhole on ESPN. We should get a small tournament or a small one-month league.
And I think it's a one-month league with six events. Cornhole's one. Pickleball's another.
Darts.
I think you go nine ball.
Pickleball's four events.
No, six.
And Olympiad. Wait, what's six events called?
I don't know. It's a six-tuple. Who knows?
We're talking in the feet of Tom.
Yeah, like
feet of Tom is definitely a...
A chipping contest.
A chipping contest.
So for sure, cornhole.
Cornhole, darts. Pickleball. I think you go pickleball.
Nine ball.
Feet of Tom.
Nine ball.
Okay.
Feet of Tom, that's five.
The sixth one.
You can that's go a pentathlon.
You go we could go five and go pentathlon.
I don't mind a pentathlon. Is there a bar game that we would, you know, no air hockey? I don't want to play that.
No.
I think those are solid.
No, I think that's solid, and I think we can do it. We could figure out something over a month time period.
Yeah.
Where we could get up to 20, 30, or 25 contestants, and we could create a little little thing where you get what you do is you get points.
Betting involved.
I think you could
always,
do betting.
Always.
No, I think it's a $5. I think it's a $5 entry per event.
I agree.
And so what you do is you get point totals. So let's say we get 20 people entered. We go top five places, get points. First place gets 5 points.
Agreed.
Second place, 4, 3, 2, mm-hmm. 1. And you do each event, and you do a tournament. So you end each event.
20 contestants, 10 teams?
No.
Or individually?
No, just
individual. It's a pentathlon.
But cornhole is hard. And like, so I'm saying those team games.
It's just, it's not a team. You can go.
You can go 1v1.
1v1.
Okay. I just wanted to make sure.
You can go 1v1.
And pickleball is a two-man sport, too.
No, you can go 1v1 in pickleball. Yeah. Okay. You just use the singles lines.
Mm-hmm.
God, if Jake wasn't here, I'd probably.
You'd be lost.
Myself. But I think it would be a fun thing it to pass the time. Nobody's working.
And no more than. Hey, we won't be in a group more than 20.
Yeah.
So we won't be.
I think we could come up with a great HMW Corona Virus Pentathlon.
Before the 2020 Summer Olympics, those might be halted.
Oh,
this ain't getting stopped.
No.
This ain't getting stopped.
And we have gold medals.
Sports might be stopping.
We do have gold medals. Could enter. Let's just say it's a $10 entry fee. No one wins money. Your entry fee goes
towards, for the medals?
No, they're not medals. Beverages. They're belt buckles.
Don't start with me.
You get a gold belt buckle? A silver belt buckle and a bronze belt buckle.
Boom. Or
it's the Corona Games. HMW first annual Corona Games.
I'm down.
No, not Corona Games.
Guys.
The HMW COVID
Games. COVID and.
But instead of 19, can we make it 20 for the year?
No, it just needs to make it COVID. Be yeah, COVID 20 games.
COVID 20.
I think it's a done deal.
I think so too. Hey, guys. Listen to another episode. We're going to be back at this thing. We got time.
Back again.
We're going to be hitting the social media. Make sure you listen. But, hey, get ready for we have a bracket coming up. We have Olympiads or pentathlon.
The COVID games.
The COVID 20 games.
The HMW COVID 20 games.
Hey, thank you guys for coming back. I missed y'all doing this. It's been a while. It's
been a minute.
Right?
The Jake is thankful.
Oh, are we signing out?
I think so.
Oh, sure. I'm Foy.
I'm Paulo.
Hit the music.
Can you blow my whistle, baby, let me know. Girl, I'm gonna show you how to do it, and we start real slow. You just Just put your lips together and you come real close. Can you blow my whistle?